Watching the Olympics on your mobile device, Spell Tower goes mountain lion, Taxi Magic steps up their game, and a review of the top puzzler, 100 Doors, today on App Judgment. This episode of App Judgment is brought to you by JackThreads.
Welcome to App Judgment, your source for mobile app news and reviews. I'm Mauricio Bobinera.
Jin Rummy.
Is that your name, Jin Rummy?
No, my name is Annie Gass.
Oh, okay, cool. We're playing with magic. Annie, fancy seeing you here on a non-Friday.
Yeah. It's odd. Usually over in the office.
Yeah. Jackie is off at New Challenger shooting the top five board game iPad apps, and that includes magic. And we're totally not playing it right. Do you have a zombie?
I have a pilgrim.
Okay. Let's forget about this. I don't think we're very good at magic. All right, well, just as a reminder, we covered this already, but don't forget that you can stream the Olympics on mobile devices. NBC Olympics Live Extra app will stream all the competitions. NBC Olympics app will have interviews, news stories, highlights, videos, live results. That's kind of confusing. Like, extras to me means like it's the other way around.
Yeah.
Like, the extras should have all the commentary stuff, but whatever.
So it is available for the iPhone, iPad, iPod Touch via Apple's App Store and select Android handset and tablet devices within Google Play. So the way it works is that you sign in with your cable provider. You have to basically prove that you're a cable subscriber.
Right. It's free, but you do need to sign in.
Yeah, you have to jump through some hoops. And if you'd like a more detailed rundown on how to stream the Olympics, check out the latest episode of Techzilla. They have a demo on how to get that.
They know what they're doing, those Techzilla guys.
Can you spell mountain lion in the newly launched Spell Tower for Mac?
No, that's way too long of a word.
Yeah, it would be hard and very unusual to actually get that word in Spell Tower. But we have reviewed Zach Gage's awesome Boggle and Tetris mashup before and even had a chance to chat with him at GDC not too long ago.
He's a cool guy.
Yes. And this new version has multiplayer mode, which is coming in a future update, so not quite yet. And it's compatible with OS X 10.7 Lion or later.
Mm-hmm. So it's mountain lion-ish, it's gonna run on basically anything, but it translates pretty well. You're way better at it than I. I was having a pretty awful time with it.
I've had plenty of practice, so.
You've been playing the Spell Tower?
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Right. I'm kind of excited for the return of just computer games, you know, just like Minecraft and.
I've decided to stand up at my desk now, and I can just watch Annie playing all her video games all
just
day now.
Snood all day long.
Yeah, snood. All right. The best new way to get a cab? Taxi Magic. Not exactly new. They've been around for a while. As a matter of fact, this is the first application that I've ever used to get a cab with my iPhone. They have had an update since getting just basically clobbered by Uber and other competitors like UberX, Lyft, GetTaxi. They're all doing the cab hailing way better than Taxi Magic was. So they did a redesign. Looks like they're doing pretty well now. It's got a cleaner UI. Obviously, getting a cab is much cheaper than getting
an Uber
being a town car, at least here in San Francisco. They've gone nationwide, so you should give Taxi Magic a second chance if you forgot about it.
And some new releases this week. Bump's new app, Flock, creates shared photo albums with friends without interrupting your life. Lapsit Pro captures stunning time-lapse videos on your Android. And finally, the Dark Knight Rises app is a musical tour of Gotham City.
Also, make sure you check out our latest Apple spoof where we kind of continue to bash on all things Siri.
Yeah, it's kind of been a trend around the office for the past couple weeks.
She's such an easy target. All right, coming up, Chris Jennings is going to give us a quick tour of the new puzzler 100 Doors on Android. But first, Annie, do I look like an idiot? I think I'm an idiot sometimes.
You always look really snappy and sharp.
And well, that's because I started using a really, really cool website called JackThreads. Because I love brands like Kid Robot, Hurley, and Stussy, but I take issue with their prices pretty often. They're kind of expensive sometimes. Well, it turns out that you can score these premium brands at up to 80% off every day. There's an invite-only shopping club just for guys called JackThreads, serving up street, skate, and surfwear brands at prices that are just freaking insane.
There is a waitlist to join, but if you head to jackthreads.com/appjudge, you can get instant access to all the hookups just for being an App Judgment viewer. So go now.
And it's free to join. Hit up jackthreads.com/appjudge, and you'll instantly start saving without having to leave the internets.
Because who ever wants to leave the internet?
Not me.
Not me either.
You may remember a few months back, Mauricio gave us an iPad walkthrough of the popular puzzle game 100 Floors. This has gone on to become one of the top downloaded apps in the iOS App Store and Google Play. So naturally, there have been a flood of similar apps being released. Today, we're looking at one called 100 Doors. It's free and available for download on both Android and iOS. As the name indicates, rather than going up an elevator as in 100 floors, 100 Doors has you simply opening up doors and entering new rooms. While the premise and gameplay is similar, the difficulty seems to be much more challenging. 100 Doors puts more of a focus on puzzles and patterns, rather than just using physics or the phone's accelerometer and gyroscope. You'll need to brush up on your algebra, knowledge of the zodiac signs, and musical memory, among other things, in order to get through each door while maintaining your sanity. At the time of this review, the app features 50 levels, but rest assured that the updates should keep coming at regular intervals until they're up to the full 100 doors. I have to admit that there were a few of these that really stumped me. Of course, it's more fulfilling to figure them out on your own, but for those who need a little help, you can download a 100 Doors Guide companion app that's free as well. This will give you the choice to see hints or full-blown solutions if you're just fed up with the current door and want to move on to the next level. Use these cheats at your own discretion. If you were already hooked on 100 floors, then there's no reason not to check out 100 Doors. It packs the same style of gameplay, but will test your brain on another level. And for those of you who get frustrated easily and aren't big puzzle fans, you should still give it a shot since you have the Guide app to fall back on if you need it. I'm also really excited to see what they have up their sleeve for the next 50 levels. So go, download it now, start flexing those brain muscles, and tell us, which door has been giving you the most trouble? Is it the one with the annoying pink teddy bear? Or is it one of the ones that makes you do way too much math? You know how to get a hold of us on email, Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter. Good luck with the puzzles, and we'll see you next time.